أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله الذي خلق السماوات والأرض وجعل الظلمات والنور، ثم الذين كفروا بربهم يعدلون. هو الذي خلقكم من طين ثم قضى أجلا، وأجل مسمى عنده، ثم أنتم تمترون. وهو الله في السماوات وفي الأرض، يعلم سركم وجهركم ويعلم ما تكسبون. وما تأتيهم من آية من آيات ربهم إلا كانوا عنها معرضين، فقد كذبوا بالحق لما جاءهم، فسوف يأتيهم أنباء ما كانوا به يستهزئون. ألم يروا كم أهلكنا من قبلهم من القرون مكناهم في الأرض ما لم نمكن لكم، وأرسلنا السماء عليهم مدرارا، وجعلنا الأنهار تجري من تحتهم، فأهلكناهم بذنوبهم وأنشأنا من بعدهم قرنا آخرين. ولو نزلنا عليك كتابا في قرطاس فلمسوه بأيديهم لقال الذين كفروا إن هذا إلا سحر مبين. وقالوا لولا أنزل عليه ملك، ولو أنزلنا ملكا لقضي الأمر ثم لا ينظرون. ولو جعلناه ملكا لجعلناه رجلا وللبسنا عليهم ما يلبسون. ولقد استهزئ برسل من قبلك فحاق بالذين سخروا منهم ما كانوا به يستهزئون. قل سيروا في الأرض ثم انظروا كيف كان عاقبة المكذبين. قل لمن ما في السماوات والأرض، قل لله، كتب على نفسه الرحمة، ليجمعنكم إلى يوم القيامة لا ريب فيه، الذين خسروا أنفسهم فهم لا يؤمنون. وله ما سكن في الليل والنهار، وهو السميع العليم. قل أغير الله أتخذ وليا فاطر السماوات والأرض وهو يطعم ولا يطعم، قل إني أمرت أن أكون أول من أسلم، ولا تكونن من المشركين. قل إني أخاف إن عصيت ربي عذاب يوم عظيم. من يصرف عنه يومئذ فقد رحمه، وذلك الفوز المبين. وإن يمسسك الله بضر فلا كاشف له إلا هو، وإن يمسسك بخير فهو على كل شيء قدير. وهو القاهر فوق عباده، وهو الحكيم الخبير. قل أي شيء أكبر شهادة؟ قل الله، شهيد بيني وبينكم. وأوحي إلي هذا القرآن لأنذركم به ومن بلغ، أئنكم لتشهدون أن مع الله آلهة أخرى، قل لا أشهد، قل إنما هو إله واحد وإنني بريء تشركون. الذين آتيناهم الكتاب يعرفونه كما يعرفون أبناءهم الذين خسروا أنفسهم فهم لا يؤمنون ومن أظلم ممن افترى على الله كذبا أو كذب بآياته إنه لا يفلح الظالمون ويوم نحشرهم جميعا ثم نقول للذين أشركوا أين شركاؤكم الذين كنتم تزعمون ثم لم تكن فتنتهم إلا أن قالوا والله ربنا ما كنا مشركين انظر كيف كذبوا على أنفسهم وضل عنهم ما كانوا يفترون ومنهم من يستمع إليك حتى وجعلنا على قلوبهم أكنة أن يفقهوه وفي آذانهم وقرا وإن يروا كل آية لا يؤمنوا بها حتى إذا جاءوك يجادلونك يقول الذين كفروا إن هذا إلا أساطير الأولين وهم ينهون عنه وينأون عنه وإن يهلكون إلا أنفسهم وما يشعرون ولو ترى إذ وقفوا على النار فقالوا يا ليت لنا نرد ولا نكذب بآيات ربنا ونكون من المؤمنين بل بدا لهم ما كانوا يخفون من قبل ولو ردوا لعادوا لما نهوا عنه وإنهم لكاذبون وقالوا إن هي إلا حياتنا الدنيا وما نحن بمبعوثين ولو ترى إذ وقفوا على ربهم قال أليس هذا بالحق؟ قالوا بلى وربنا قال فذوقوا العذاب بما كنتم تكفرون قد خسر الذين كذبوا بلقاء الله حتى إذا جاءتهم الساعة بغتة قالوا يا حسرتنا على ما فرطنا فيها وهم يحملون أوزارهم على ظهورهم ألا ساء ما يزرون وما الحياة الدنيا إلا لعب ولهو وللدار الآخرة خير للذين يتقون أفلا تعقلون قد نعلم إنه ليحزنك الذين يقولون فإنهم لا يكذبونك ولكن الظالمين بآيات الله يجحدون ولقد كذبت رسل من قبلك فصبروا على ما كذبوا وأوذوا حتى أتاهم نصرنا ولا مبدل لكلمات الله ولقد جاءك من نبأ المرسلين وإن كان كبر عليك إعراضهم فإن استطعت أن تبتغي نفقا في الأرض أو سلما في السماء فتأتيهم بآية ولو شاء الله لجمعهم على الهدى فلا تكونن من الجاهلين إنما يستجيب الذين يسمعون والموتى يبعثهم الله ثم إليه يرجعون وقالوا لولا نزل عليه آية من ربه قل إن الله قادر على أن ينزل آية ولكن أكثرهم لا يعلمون وما من دابة في الأرض ولا طائر يطير بجناحيه إلا أمم أمثالكم ما فرطنا في الكتاب من شيء ثم إلى ربهم يحشرون والذين كذبوا بآياتنا صم وبكم في الظلمات من يشأ الله يضلله ومن يشأ يجعله على صراط مستقيم ومن يشأ يجعله على صراط مستقيم قل أرأيتكم إن أتاكم عذاب الله أو أتتكم الساعة أغير الله تدعون إن كنتم صادقين بل إياه تدعون فيكشف ما تدعون إليه إن شاء وتنسون ما تشركون ولقد أرسلنا إلى أمم من قبلك فأخذناهم بالبأساء والضراء لعلهم يتضرعون فلولا إذ جاءهم بأسنا تضرعوا ولكن قست قلوبهم وزين لهم الشيطان ما كانوا يعملون فلما نسوا ما ذكروا به فتحنا عليهم أبواب كل شيء حتى إذا فرحوا بما أوتوا أخذناهم بغتة فإذا هم مبلسون فقطع دابر القوم الذين ظلموا والحمد لله رب العالمين قل أرأيتم إن أخذ الله سمعكم وأبصاركم وختم على قلوبكم من إله غير الله يأتيكم به انظر كيف نصرف الآيات ثم هم يصرفون قل أرأيتكم إن أتاكم عذاب الله بغتة أو جهرة هل يهلك إلا القوم الظالمون وما نرسل المرسلين إلا مبشرين ومنذرين فمن آمن وأصلح فلا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون والذين كذبوا بآياتنا يمسهم العذاب بما كانوا يفسقون قل لا أقول لكم عندي خزائن الله ولا أعلم الغيب ولا أقول لكم إني ملك إن أتبع إلا ما يوحى إلي قل هل يستوي الأعمى والبصير أفلا تتفكرون وأنذر به الذين يخافون أن يحشروا إلى ربهم ليس لهم من دونه ولي ولا شفيع لعلهم يتقون ولا تطرد الذين يدعون ربهم بالغداة والعشي يريدون وجهك ما عليك من حسابهم من شيء وما من حسابك عليهم من شيء فتطردهم فتكون من الظالمين وكذلك فتنا بعضهم ببعض ليقولوا أهؤلاء من الله عليهم من بيننا أليس الله بأعلم بالشاكرين وإذا جاءك الذين يؤمنون بآياتنا فقل سلام عليكم كتب ربكم على نفسه الرحمة أنه من عمل منكم سوءا بجهالة ثم تاب من بعده وأصلح فإنه غفور رحيم وكذلك نفصل الآيات ولتستبين سبيل المجرمين قل إني نهيت أن أعبد الذين تدعون من دون الله قل لا أتبع أهواءكم قد ضللت إذا وما أنا من المهتدين قد ضللت إذا وما أنا من المهتدين قل إني على بينة من ربي وكذبتم به ما عندي ما تستعجلون به إن الحكم إلا لله يقص الحق وهو خير الفاصلين قل لو أن عندي ما تستعجلون به لقضي الأمر بيني وبينكم والله أعلم بالظالمين وعنده مفاتح الغيب لا يعلمها إلا هو ويعلم ما في البر والبحر وما تسقط من ورقة إلا يعلمها ولا حبة في ظلمات الأرض ولا رطب ولا يابس إلا في كتاب مبين وهو الذي يتوفاكم بالليل ويعلم ما جرحتم بالنهار ثم يبعثكم فيه ليقضى أجل مسمى ثم إليه مرجعكم ثم ينبئكم بما كنتم تعملون وهو القاهر فوق عباده ويرسل عليكم حفظة حتى إذا جاء أحدكم الموت توفته رسلنا وهم لا يفرطون ثم ردوا إلى الله مولاهم الحق ألا له الحكم وهو أسرع الحاسبين قل من ينجيكم من ظلمات البر والبحر تدعونه تضرعا وخفية لئن أنجانا من هذه لنكونن من الشاكرين قل الله ينجيكم منها ومن كل كرب ثم أنتم تشركون قل هو القاهر على أن يبعث عليكم عذابا من فوقكم أو من تحت أرجلكم أو يلبسكم شيعا ويذيق بعضكم بأس بعض انظر كيف نصرف الآيات لعلهم يفقهون وكذب به قومك وهو الحق قل لست عليكم بوكيل لكل نبأ مستقر وسوف تعلمون وإذا رأيت الذين يخوضون في آياتنا فأعرض عنهم حتى يخوضوا في حديث غيره وإما ينسينك الشيطان فلا تقعد بعد الذكرى مع القوم الظالمين وما على الذين يتقون من حسابهم من شيء ولكن ذكرى لعلهم يتقون وذر الذين اتخذوا دينهم لعبا ولهوا وغرتهم الحياة الدنيا وذكر به أن تبسل نفس بما كسبت ليس لها من دون الله ولي ولا شفيع وإن تعدل كل عدل لا يؤخذ منها أولئك الذين أبسلوا بما كسبوا لهم شراب من حميم وعذاب أليم بما كانوا يكفرون قل أندعو من دون الله ما لا ينفعنا ولا يضرنا ونرد على أعقابنا بعد إذ هدانا الله كالذي استهوته الشياطين في الأرض حيران له أصحاب يدعونه إلى الهدى ائتنا قل إن هدى الله هو الهدى وأمرنا لنسلم لرب العالمين وأن أقيموا الصلاة واتقوه وهو الذي إليه تحشرون وهو الذي خلق السماوات والأرض بالحق ويوم يكون كن فيكون ويوم يقول كن فيكون قوله الحق وله الملك يوم ينفخ في الصور عالم الغيب والشهادة وهو الحكيم الخبير وإذ قال إبراهيم لأبيه آزر أتتخذ أصناما آلهة إني أراك وقومك في ضلال مبين وكذلك نري إبراهيم ملكوت السماوات والأرض وليكون من الموقنين فلما جن عليه الليل رأى كوكبا قال هذا ربي فلما أفل قال لا أحب الآفلين فلما رأى القمر بازغا قال هذا ربي فلما أفل قال لئن لم يهدني ربي لأكونن من القوم الضالين فلما رأى الشمس بازغة قال هذا ربي هذا أكبر فلما أفلت قال يا قوم إني بريء مما تشركون إني وجهت وجهي للذي فطر السماوات والأرض حنيفا وما أنا من المشركين وحاجه قومه قال أتحاجوني في الله وقد هدان ولا أخاف ما تشركون به إلا أن يشاء ربي شيئا وسع ربي كل شيء علما أفلا تتذكرون وكيف أخاف ما أشركتم ولا تخافون أنكم أشركتم بالله ما لم ينزل به عليكم سلطانا ما لم ينزل به عليكم سلطانا فأي الفريقين أحق بالأمن إن كنتم تعلمون الذين آمنوا ولم يلبسوا إيمانهم بظلم أولئك لهم الأمن وهم مهتدون وتلك حجتنا آتيناها إبراهيم على قومه نرفع درجات من نشاء إن ربك حكيم عليم ووهبنا له إسحاق ويعقوب كلا هدينا ونوحا هدينا من قبل ومن ذريته داود وسليمان وأيوب ويوسف وموسى وهارون وكذلك نجزي المحسنين وزكريا ويحيى وعيسى وإلياس كل من الصالحين وإسماعيل واليسع ويونس ولوطا وكلا فضلنا على العالمين ومن آبائهم وذرياتهم وإخوانهم واجتبيناهم وهديناهم إلى صراط مستقيم ذلك هدى الله يهدي به من يشاء من عباده ولو أشركوا لحبط عنهم ما كانوا يعملون أولئك الذين آتيناهم الكتاب والحكم والنبوة فإن يكفر بها هؤلاء فقد وكلنا بها قوما ليسوا بها بكافرين أولئك الذين هداهم الله فبهداهم اقتدِ قل لا أسألكم عليه أجرا إن هو إلا ذكر للعالمين صدق الله العظيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الحمد لله رب العالمين. So today I was reciting from Surah Al-An'am. Surah Al-An'am, that's Surah number 6. Surah number 6 of the Quran. Today we won't get to discuss Surah Al-An'am, but inshallah tomorrow inshallah we'll start the discussion on Surah Al-An'am. There's a very crucial part of the surah that I recited today that I enjoyed myself tremendously. I always enjoy reciting it. It's very deep and very emotional, alhamdulillah. And it's filled with lessons. It's filled with so many lessons. And you know, the Quran is just amazing, wallahi. So anyways, finishing off from yesterday, talking about Surah Al-Ma'idah. Surah Al-Ma'idah, the table spread. The table spread, or the set table. You know, like the dining table that's spread and set for you to eat on. That's what Al-Ma'idah is. Back home, you can, you know, in Gambia, you know, we eat on the floor for the most part. So, you know, the sheet that we put on the floor is also called the Ma'ida. That's what Al-Ma'ida means. The sheet that you set down to eat, right? So the surah is called Al-Ma'ida for that reason, for the reason that I'm going to be coming to, inshallah, today, in our today's lesson, inshallah, of the running translation. But what I want to do, inshallah, is first finish off from yesterday. Yesterday, I stopped when Musa alayhi salam told his people. He told his people to enter upon Jerusalem and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them victory. And they said, no, they wouldn't. They said, "Inna fiha qawman jabbarina wa inna lan nadukhulaha abadan ma damu fiha. Fadhhab anta wa rabbuka faqatila inna hauna qaidun." You remember yesterday when I said that the Bani Israel, they told Musa, "You and your Lord, you go fight, and we're just going to sit here and wait." Extremely disrespectful, extremely arrogant, extremely dismissive of their prophet, alayhi salam. And us as Muslims, we, you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in many places in the Quran, and there is a place that I will come to, and I will talk about the respect that we're supposed to have for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we'll dive deeper into the language, the Arabic language, and we will go and tell the stories, inshallah, and put everything in context of some stories where the Quran was revealed because of an incident, and the Quran was revealed because of such and such incident. We will go through all of that, inshallah, this Ramadan. But continuing on, so his people told him this, "We're going to sit here and fight. We're going to sit here and we won't fight." And what did he tell his people? Right after that, he told Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that, you know, this is, you know, these are my people. What am I going to say? But I am free from everything that they do. So he told Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that I'm, "Qala Rabbi inni la amliku illa nafsi wa akhi. Fafruq baynana wa bayna al-qawmi al-fasiqin." He, Musa alayhi salam, prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After they told him this, he said, "Oh, Ya Rabb, oh my Rabb, indeed I have control only over me and my brother Harun. So separate us from the sinful." Meaning, you know, it's a very important lesson. Musa alayhi salam is telling his people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, "Please separate myself and my brother from these sinful people." Right? From the sinful people. So you see that, you know, it's a lesson for us to make sure that we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to always separate us from those who are sinful and those who disobey him, because we don't want to be known and associated with a crowd that disobeys Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a crowd that, you know, is extremely sinful and all they do is commit sins and they don't obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's laws. So we want to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to always separate us from the sinful. فَفْرُقْ بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَ الْقَوْمِ الْفَاسِقِينَ. Those who are disobedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Next ayah. قَالَ فَإِنَّهَا مُحَرَّمَةٌ عَلَيْهِمْ أَرْبَعِينَ سَنَةً يَتِيهُونَ فِي الْأَرْضِ فَلَا تَأْسَ عَلَى الْقَوْمِ الْفَاسِقِينَ. And this is the last ayah of the story. This is the last part of the story. When Musa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Musa alayhi salam, and he tells us in the Quran, because of what they said, because they told Musa alayhi salam, "You go and your Lord, you fight, we're just going to sit here." That disrespect and that disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they were punished by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and made to wander around and not able to enter Jerusalem for 40 years. 40 sana. For 40 years, they were made to just wander on earth aimlessly without having a place to call home. They weren't able to enter Jerusalem because of their disobedience. So this was their punishment. So what happened was, by the time 40 years came, all of those people who had disobeyed and disrespected Musa alayhi salam, they had died off. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made sure that generation was completely gone. And then the generation that now that inherited Jerusalem was under Musa alayhi salam's boy servant, who was named Yusha bin Nun, who was also a prophet of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the one who fought jihad, and then through that jihad, they were able to enter Jerusalem and conquer Jerusalem, and they lived there for the rest of, time until, Isa alayhi salam came and so on and so forth. So they were able to inherit it then. Okay, so that ends that story of Musa alayhi salam and his people and their disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So now, as I promised, we're going to go to the reason why the surah is called Al-Ma'idah. Al-Ma'idah. And that has to do with the last two pages of Surah Al-Ma'idah. And it starts off, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَوْمَ يَجْمَعُ اللَّهُ الرُّسُلَ فَيَقُولُ مَاذَا أُجِبْتُمْ قَالُوا لَا عِلْمَ لَنَا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ عَلَّامُ الْغُيُوبِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, do not forget the day of Qiyamah, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will gather the Rusul and ask them, he will gather the prophets and ask them, what response or what reply did you receive from the people when you called them to believe in Tawheed? They will submit. We have no knowledge about the beliefs of beliefs they concealed in their hearts and about what they did after we left them. Most surely only you are the knower of the unseen. So that's the first ayah. يَوْمَ يَجْمَعُ اللَّهُ الرُّسُلَ فَيَقُولُ مَاذَا أُجِبْتُمْ قَالُوا لَا عِلْمَ لَنَا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ عَلَّامُ الْغُيُوبِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is fast-forwarding us now. We've left this world. So now we fast-forward to the day of judgment. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he does that a lot in the Quran, where, you know, time is not a thing for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He created time, so he's outside of time. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about something that happened in the past, he can be talking about something that's happening in the present, and he can be talking about something that's going to happen in the future. A lot of times in the Quran, what happens is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes our minds to the day of judgment. And he talks about that day. So يَوْمَ يَجْمَعُ اللَّهُ الرُّسُلُ. يَوْمَ يَجْمَعُ اللَّهُ الرُّسُلُ, meaning when Allah, the day when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will gather all of the prophets that were sent, our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam included, and they will be asked, what did the people do when you called them to Tawheed? What was their response when you called them to Tawheed? And the prophets will say, you know, we did what we could, but after we left them, we don't know their affairs. We don't know what happened after we left them, right? We don't know how they ended up. We were only able to call them, you know, to Tawheed. قَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي دَعَوْتُ قَوْمِي لَيْلًا وَنَهَارًا فَلَمْ يَزِدْهُمْ دُعَائِي إِلَّا فِرَارًا وَإِنِّي كُلَّمَا دَعَوْتُهُمْ لِتَغْفِرَ لَهُمْ جَعَلُوا أَصَابِعَهُمْ فِي آذَانِهِمْ وَاسْتَغْشَوْا ثِيَابَهُمْ وَأَسَرُّوا وَاسْتَكْبَرُوا اسْتِكْبَارًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in another place in the Quran, when Nuh alayhi salam is calling his people to Tawheed, he called them, he said, إِنِّي دَعَوْتُ قَوْمِي لَيْلًا وَنَهَارًا. He said, I called them during the day and during the night for 950 years, day in and day out, he was calling them. But every time he would call them, they would run away and put their hands over their ears and not want to hear what he has to say for 950 years. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will gather all of the anbiya, all of the prophets, and he'll ask them, what did they say? And he will say, we had no idea. We have no idea. Maybe some of us listened and say, okay, we obey. But what was in our hearts? We have no knowledge of what was in the hearts of the people. That's what they will answer. We have no knowledge about that. Only you, Ya Allah, you know. You are the knower of the unseen. Okay? So next ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِذْ قَالَ اللَّهُ يَا عِيسَى ابْنَ مَرْيَمَ اذْكُرْ نِعْمَتِي عَلَيْكَ وَعَلَى وَالِدَتِكَ إِذْ أَيَّدْتُكَ بِرُوحِ الْقُدُسِ تُكَلِّمُ النَّاسَ فِي الْمَهْدِ وَكَهْلًا. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala starts talking about Isa alayhi salam and Maryam alayhi salam. So So he starts talking about Isa alayhi salam. He says, do not forget on the day of Qiyamah, again, we're still in the day of judgment, when Allah will say, O Isa, son of Maryam, remember my favor to you and to your mother when I assisted you by means of Ruh al-Qudus. What is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about here? Ruh al-Qudus. So when Maryam alayhi salam, our mother Maryam alayhi salam, the mother of Jesus, righteous woman, chaste woman, never disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ever. She is actually the best woman that's ever lived and come on the face of the earth. Through, we know this through the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, where he says, "Khayru nisa'il alamina arba'a." The best four women that ever lived and stepped foot on this earth are four. And then who's the first one? Maryam ibnat Imran. The first one, the best woman that's ever lived is Maryam, the daughter of Imran, right? So that's who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about. That's Mary, son of Jesus. I mean, that's Mary, mother of Jesus, sorry. Mary, mother of Jesus. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, remember our favor on you through Ruh al-Qudus. Ruh al-Qudus is Angel Jibreel. When Maryam alayhi salam was pregnant with Jesus, she was alone. She had no one, because we know that her pregnancy was a miracle by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He blew into her, the Ruh al-Qudus blew into her, and then she was pregnant. She's never touched a man, she's never had any relationship with any man ever, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through a miracle, made her pregnant. So she concealed this pregnancy as much as she could, but when she was about to deliver, she had no one around her. So Jibreel alayhi salam was there for her. And in Surah Maryam, Jibreel alayhi salam is having a conversation with her, and he actually goes on and he says, you know, pull upon, like, go to this specific area where there's a palm tree. So there was a palm tree that she was, when she was about to deliver the baby, who was Jesus. She was under a palm tree, and what happened was, Jibreel alayhi salam came to her and said to her, shake the palm tree, and if you shake the palm tree, you will get some sustenance from that palm tree. So Jibreel alayhi salam helped her deliver Isa alayhi salam. So that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking about here. And spoke to you, and you spoke to the people while in the cradle as a baby. And this is talking about when she was first, Isa alayhi salam was first born, and the people were saying, oh, ya ukhta Harun, ma kana abuki imra'a saw'in wa ma kanat ummuki baghiya. This is the story when she took the baby back and she's living among her people, and the people, you know, they're saying, oh, ya ukhta Harun, oh, or sister of Harun, we don't know you to be, you know, we don't know your father or mother to be someone, you know, that, you know, that was disobedient. How could you get pregnant out of wedlock? Right? How could you have a baby and you're not married? Meaning this was haram. How could you do something so evil? So Maryam alayhi salam didn't say anything, right? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fa'asharat ilayhi. Qalu kayfa nukallimu man kana fil mahdi sabiyya. So she pointed to the baby. She pointed to Isa alayhi salam at that point, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told her, like, you don't speak. We will take care of this. So she pointed to Isa alayhi salam, like, go ahead. What is your defense of these people? And that's when Isa alayhi salam says the famous words, "Inni abdullah," right? That's recorded in Surah Maryam. فَأَشَارَتْ إِلَيْهِ قَالُوا كَيْفَ نُكَلِّمُ مَنْ كَانَ فِي الْمَهْدِ صَبِيًّا. When she pointed at the baby, they looked at her like, are you crazy? How can a baby speak? He's just a newborn baby. How can he possibly speak? And Isa alayhi salam opened his mouth at that point and say, "Inni abdullah." Certainly, I am the slave of Allah. Atani al-kitaba wa ja'alani nabiyya. He has given me, meaning he has given me the book, the Injil. Atani al-kitab. I bring this book from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa ja'alani nabiyya. And he has made me a prophet. Wa ja'alani mubarakan aynama kuntu wa awsani bis salati wa zakati ma dumtu hayya. He gives this long speech that is recorded in Surah Maryam as a baby, as a newborn baby. And that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is referencing in this ayah. When he says that, when I taught you the book, When I taught you the book and I taught you wisdom, the Torah and the Injil, right? The Torah and the Injil. When you would create for when you would create the form of a bird, and now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going through the miracles that He allowed Isa alayhi salam to perform. And it's really beautiful. He goes through وَإِذْ تَخْلُقُ مِنَ الطِّينِ كَهَيْئَةِ الطَّيْرِ بِإِذْنِي فَتَنْفُخُ فِيهَا فَتَكُونُ طَيْرًا بِإِذْنِي وَتُبْرِئُ الْأَكْمَهَ وَالْأَبْرَصَ بِإِذْنِي وَإِذْ تُخْرِجُ الْمَوْتَى بِإِذْنِي وَإِذْ خَفَفْتُ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ عَنْكَ إِذْ جِئْتَهُمْ بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ فَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْهُمْ إِنْ هَذَا إِلَّا سِحْرٌ مُبِينٌ. This ayah is extremely important. This ayah is extremely important. Because I'm going to read the whole ayah in English and then I will explain. So Allah, I'm going to start from the beginning again. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when Allah will say, O Isa, son of Mary, remember my favor to you and to your mother when I assisted you by means of Ruh al-Qudus, again, meaning Jibreel alayhi salam, and you spoke to the people while in the cradle as a little baby. And in manhood, when you returned to the world before Qiyamah, remember, when I taught you the book and I taught you wisdom and the Torah and the Injil, right? When I taught you the book, meaning the wisdom, the Torah and the Injil. Remember also when you would create the form of a bird from sand, right? When He would create a bird from clay, from sand, blow into it and it would become a living bird by my order or by my by me allowing you to do it, right? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, by my order. And you would cure those born blind and the leper by my order, and when you would raise the dead from their graves by my order. And remember when I restrained the Bani Israel from killing you when you came to them with clear signs, clear miracles, and the kafirun from them said, these miracles is obviously just magic, right? This ayah is extremely important for a few reasons. Number one, this is, you know, for our Christian brothers and sisters who say that Jesus is the Son of God, this is a clear ayah saying that this is, you know, this is not true. He said Jesus is the Son of Mary. Jesus is not the Son of God. And all these miracles that He performed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after every miracle, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, bi'idhni, by me allowing you to do it, by my order you were able to take clay and make it into a bird, blow in it and became alive. That was because I allowed you to do that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying. And you were able to, you know, just put your hand over the person who was sick and you were able to cure them. And that was because I allowed you to do that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying. And you were able to raise the dead, which is the most important miracle. You were able to raise the dead from their graves because I allowed you to do that. It's a miracle that I allowed you to do so the people would see, right? But what happened was the people took this and they started calling Isa alayhi salam God and saying that he's a deity because only a God can do such things. No, a man can do this if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows the man to do it. Ibrahim alayhi salam was thrown in fire and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the fire cool for him. قُلْنَا يَا نَارُ كُونِي بَرْدًا وَسَلَامًا عَلَىٰ إِبْرَاهِيمٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the fire to be cool and to be peaceful for Ibrahim alayhi salam. So if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can do that, why can't Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow Isa alayhi salam to raise the dead by his order? Why can't Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow Isa alayhi salam to heal the sick because he allowed him to do that? Why can't Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow Isa alayhi salam to take clay, mold it into a bird and blow in it and it become alive? Why can't Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow Isa alayhi salam to do that, right? Subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who allowed him to do all of these things. So by every time he says, you did a miracle, he says, by my order, I allowed you to do this, I allowed you to do this, I allowed you to do this. And he also says, I'm the one who restrained, I'm the one who kept Bani Israel from killing you. That's another thing. We don't believe Isa alayhi salam died and was risen after 3 days. We don't believe that in Islam. We believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected Isa alayhi salam from Bani Israel when they wanted to kill him. He protected Isa alayhi salam when they wanted to kill him. How did he do that? When they thought that they crucified him, they actually, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala switched the who was being crucified and took the soul of Isa alayhi salam and rose it up to the heavens, right? And that's how Isa alayhi salam, when he's going to come back, he's going to come back from the heavens, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took his soul up. So Isa alayhi salam is not dead. Isa alayhi salam is alive and well, and he is chilling in the heaven, right? And you ask, which heaven is he in? That question is answered in the Isra wal Mi'raj. That question is answered in the Isra wal Mi'raj. When the Prophet ﷺ went to the seven heavens, in the first heaven, he met Adam alayhi salam, right? In the first heaven, he met Adam alayhi salam. In the second heaven, he met Harun. I'm sorry, in the second heaven, he met Yahya and Isa alayhi salam. So in the second heaven is when he met Isa alayhi salam, and then in the third heaven he met Yusuf alayhi salam. Fourth heaven he met Idris alayhi salam. Fifth heaven he met Harun alayhi salam. Sixth heaven he met Musa alayhi salam. In the seventh heaven he met Ibrahim alayhi salam. But in the second heaven he met Yahya and Isa alayhi salam. So Isa alayhi salam right now is in the second heaven, and he's just hanging out there, just waiting for him, waiting to come back on earth. Because we believe that he is the Messiah. We believe that Isa alayhi salam is going to come back, and he's going to, inshallah, you know, fight on our side as Muslims, and he's going to be the part of the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He's going to be part of the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. That is a very important thing that we need to know. Isa alayhi salam is not going to come back and say, okay, I'm a prophet now, you guys have to follow me, this and that. He said, I'm part of the Ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. You know, that's what Isa alayhi salam is going to say. So we don't believe that Isa alayhi salam is dead. We believe that he was risen, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took his soul before Bani Israel could kill him. And he's going to come back, inshallah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when I restrained Bani Israel from killing you, when you came to them with clear signs, when you came to them with clear signs, they wanted to kill you, but I saved you. And from the and he saved him from the kafirun when they said, these miracles are but obvious magic. And this is where I'm going to stop for today, inshallah. And I will we'll probably be talking about these last two pages of Surah Ma'idah for a while, because there's a lot to talk about. The ayats are long, and there's a lot to discuss from these ayats. So we just went through the first two ayats, Yawma yajma'u Allahu ar-rusul. We actually just went through the first ayah, Yawma yajma'u Allah. No, we went through two ayahs, sorry. Yawma yajma'u Allahu ar-rusula fa yaqulu madha ujibtum, and then the very next ayah, idh qala Allahu ya Isa, ya Isa ibn Maryam. So we went through those two ayahs. So inshallah, tomorrow we'll go through maybe one more ayah or two more ayahs, inshallah, until we finish the story. It's a very important story for us to know, because number one, we have Christian brothers and sisters, especially if you're living in the Gambia, we live, you know, amongst them, and they live amongst us, and we live in harmony and stuff. But what if they come to you and they ask you these questions? You need to be able to answer them. You need to be able to say, oh, hey, this is what we believe in when it comes to Isa alayhi salam. This is how it's different from your belief, but that is okay, because we can still live in harmony. Just because we have these differences doesn't mean that we can't live in harmony. So these are the stories that help us to understand that, where Muslims and Christians can live together. Even though we have differences, we can still live together, inshallah. So I'll stop here, inshallah. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-Hakim wa naf'ani wa iyyakum bima fihi min al-ayati wa dhikr al-Hakim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.